Hello everyone and welcome to Usability. Today we are going to see how to play World of Tanks Blitz on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install World of Tanks Blitz and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5. Which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play World of Tanks Blitz. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, to start we have to open our main browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's go to the current URL I'm highlighting in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type it, simply because I added the clickable link in the description of this video and the first main comment. We landed there on the website of Usability. Where we include an in-depth explanation on the way to download and install World of Tanks Blitz on personal computer. We scroll lower a little bit and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on this link, we get to the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will load to play World of Tanks Blitz on our PC. It is now obvious that we access several pros of preferring using this emulator. Now we are ready to start downloading the World of Tanks Blitz by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. Next step is clicking on that button. And the download takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It is a file we have to execute. What we are going to do now is to run the installer. Okay, so we have to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the computer. We have said yes. I minimize the internet browser to find the installer much better. The installer is straightforward. It contains two options, install, and setup path. I will show you what setup path really does. We only simply click on it. So we note that we end up with here the path where in fact the emulator will be placed. If we prefer to change this folder we have got to click on that browse option. Therefore we decide on another folder and install the emulator exactly where we like. I am going to leave it by default. Then, I click on back. And I just click install. Now, there it is. The setup begins and it will continue in the download of those megabytes which are represented on this computer screen. The time you save it on your computer, it might possibly be more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate might go faster or slower, subject to your type of access to the web and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator hosting servers. Now they are progressing incredibly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator happens to be started instantly. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar that will advance to the right then when it gets into the end, the emulator can be started for the first time. In reality the emulator has been started, here it is for the first time. Before we continue, as you will notice, it has made two icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is definitely the only one we're concerned about. The moment we have to start World of Tanks Blitz on our PC, we twice click on this icon and consequently run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's conduct the following step, that is a must. And this is to log on to the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you can discover the Google Play is started. At this point we need to sign in. At this moment once we're there, we must conduct this next step that is imperative. So that we mouse click on, sign in. Now it shows, checking info. It could from time to time get stuck in, checking info. Additionally it isn't going to move ahead. If so, you may attempt to log in after a few hours and it will surely quite likely be repaired. Now we're going to provide our username and password. The email address ought to be a Gmail email as well as its matching password. As an example you make use of the same exact email you're using at the moment in your YouTube account. Then I am going to enter my data and I'll go back when I have accomplished it. That's it, info typed in. This is Google welcoming us and offering us their tools. We will approve them all by simply clicking, I agree. Next, it make us possible to save to the Google Cloud. You could leave it selected, it's going to create a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you do what you want. We mouse click on accept. Google Play is started automatically and instantly. To install the video game, we have got to go to the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on the app icon indicated green colored. Right now that we are discovering the desktop of this emulator, we see that we have now right here the install game option. We then click on this button. There we have got the game app. Why don't we click on now on the install link that I'm showing now in green color. And this will commence the software installation. At this point it will install the game. It could take quite some time or perhaps it could also be almost immediate. That all varies on the web connection. This has actually finished installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking this specific button that I am emphasizing in green, that allows you to launch World of Tanks Blitz for the first time. We are now on the emulator desktop, then we're going to simply click that new World of Tanks Blitz app icon that was provided. The game app is started for the first time. There we end up with it. I can also click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the volume level of the emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we could turn on the large monitor, for which we have two options. This is actually the first one. We mouse click on this app icon which I'm identifying in green color. And the monitor is maximized, offering one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In case we need to run the video game in full screen, we select this particular icon. And we might presently be enjoying the game in 100% screen setting. To leave the 100% screen functionality, hit the F11 key. And consequently we would certainly now be in normal display screen setting. At present, I am choosing to demonstrate you the computer keyboard mapping which is definitely rather appealing. That strategy we will probably be ready to play the game app far more easily. The first task is to click this keyboard icon. And there you will have the ability to get the required configurations. I most certainly will put the default settings, though if you really want to improve this, you may well do this with no problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is entirely in our own language. From time to time it happens that your emulator is started in the wrong language, for instance, in Japanese. And consequently to place it in the proper language we go here to the cogwheel. And there inside of additional settings, we click the language drop down. We can easily decide on the language we prefer, Italian, Mandarin, and so forth. As soon as the language is decided, we are going to save, the emulator would restart, as well as the video game. The next time we launch it, will of course be in the opted for language. At this moment, you can find another information that we will need to take into account, and this is that we will get an email telling that a completely new equipment has been connected with this Google account. It definitely will check with us if we are the ones who have associated with that device. Yes, we should not get worried, considering the fact that emulator is simulating an Google Android tablet or smartphone. And to find which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we arrive right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Therefore we browse here to the model choice. And right here we discover that the emulator is simulating a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for our training. I hope you appreciated it, specifically that you thought it was informative. If that's so, bring it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and any comments, requests or suggestions, leave them in the comment box down below. You could possibly also leave a remark on my Twitch channel. I actually do live streams ever so often. You have it down below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Just click any of the videos which are usually showing up on the screen and let's have fun again in the next training videos. Bye.